you can find traditional tree houses all over the world, but you cannot find something like this. We don't do this traditional treehouse. We try to do some modern design together with the treehouses. So that was the concept also. It should be something new. The idea was to attract people who are interested in travel and design and architecture. Many of these people who live in Sweden, Stockholm, the main cities in the south of Sweden, not all of them have been up in the north. I think we are far away. We are up in the, we call it Swedish Lapland, and you have just 45 minutes to the Arctic Circle from here. It's a remote place, and it's not much people in this area. And we have a long winter. Trees and the forest is really important for us who live here. I mean, that give you, you can make trekking, you can hunting, you can go and fishing, you can do everything in the forest, picking berries. So that's a really big part of the lifestyle up here in the north. And also, of course, it's a, for the forest industry, it's a big deal for them too. The forest industry is one of the biggest in Sweden, so we export a lot of timber. But what we do here is more to keep the trees here and do something else about the idea of trees. I was born here and growing up here. Me and my wife Britta was both from this area. Yeah, we start, my Britta started for 11 years ago and opened the guesthouse, Britta's Pensionat. And the story, how we started Treehotel, it's another story. It's, we run the guesthouse, we have not so good business, it, few people, few international guests. And then a friend of us come up from, he lives in Stockholm, and he have decided to come back where he grew up in the area also to make a documentary film and build a tree house and tell a story about the trees. And then when he was ready with the tree house, he doesn't use that so much. So we asked him if he can rent it out, and we start to run it for 2 years. But we noticed that everyone who was staying in the tree house was very happy when they come down to breakfast. But the experience to stay high up in the tree with a connection to the childhood, something really special. Then we understand maybe that's something we can do. So we have started to think about to make our own tree houses, but we didn't know how they should look. So then I was in Russia in 2008 on a fishing trip, and in this trip it was booked three of the best architects in Sweden. So it was very easy to talk with them around the campfire and ask them if they want to design tree houses. Of course, they love the idea to be a designer of a tree houses. This was one of the first room we hang up in 2010, and it's called the cabin. Like a cabin, that's the... you have these houses we can find in Sweden, like a caravan.
Oh, it's like a caravan. So the idea is to give a feel of something from the ground, but up high.
Yeah. Designed by the Swedish architect Morten Suren from Stockholm. And it's a double room for two persons with a perfect view over the river here. High up, it's the highest room, 10 meters high. This is the mirrorcube. It's a double room for two persons, designed by the Swedish architect Tom Videgård from Stockholm. And you can see it sit on one single tree in the middle, holding up the whole building. So it's, and it's a weight of 6 tons of this room, covered by mirror glass. And when we saw that, we say, it looks impossible, but we say, yes, we're going to build it. It's an 8mm hardened glass, but inside is aluminium frame. Inside is wood panel with plywood of a pine tree. So from inside you can see out, you can look out the windows in all directions. Even the roof is have a window on the top there.
So is there a certain type of glass that you're able to look out but not
yeah,
see in?
Yeah, exactly.
What is it?
I think they call them spion glass, where you can see one way but not the other way.
And the idea is to kind of reflect nature back at you.
Yeah, exactly. So it fits in the nature. When it's a beautiful place, it's a beautiful room. And it's just nearly invisible because it's just reflecting the nature around there. So it's very spectacular. Room to stay in. I think that the architect want to create something really special, a cube in the nature. Something really more than together with the nature. And you see, it works together. I haven't seen something like this before in the world, never. Especially never in the tree, of course. This is the bird's nest. It's a family room with four beds. The idea of design, we leave that to our architect to create some new idea. We give them really free hands, create your dream of a tree house, but it must work as a hotel room year round in these conditions in north of Sweden.
What am I getting?
The concept, it's something natural you can find in the forest here in this area. It's a bird's nest, but it's a big one for a family.
So there are branches, actual branches on the outside?
Yeah, this is the branch that we find in the forest here. It's just dry branches we cover it with.
And inside? There's wooden panels?
It's wooden panels and it's two bedrooms, mm-hmm. Toilet, water, everything like the other. It's modern, but it's something natural. I mean, you can find a bird's nest somewhere here, mm-hmm. And this is the bigger one. So,
do animals come through here? And I mean, do they get it? Are birds actually nesting in the area?
The birds are nesting outside a bird's nest. Yeah, they like it because it's already prepared. And this was the same architect who made two rooms. He made the bird's nest and the UFO. And both of them was the opposite thinking. A UFO should not expect to find it in the forest like this. His concept was two different ideas.
What you can find in the forest and what you would never find.
Exactly, the natural or the
The UFO has landed.
When we come back to Sweden after the fishing tour, we start directly and invite architects and took them up to the area and so show them the forest here. And then they find a place and they measure the trees and check everything. And then they went home and start the work. And it took about 3-4 months and they come up and show their drawings, ideas. And when we saw that, we say, it looks impossible, but we say, yes, we're going to build it. And after that, we start the process. First, you must do is contact the government for the construction permit. Of course, they was really surprised to have an application about three hotels. And they say they have no rules about three hotels, so they must create something.
So did they create rules for you, or how is it?
I mean, they must use the ordinary rules on ground. But it took only 8 weeks, and they was say yes, and then we could buy this land from a private owner. I mean, this land was belonged to a private owner and he has just sold it to a forest company. They're going to cut it down. That was the idea, because it's 100-year-old trees. But we stopped it in the last minute and buy it from him. So now we saved the trees also for the future.
far north. We're almost at the Arctic Circle.
I think Santa lives here. But Shma, in wintertime, remember their snow?
Yeah.
Well, Santa lives here.
We were on our way to sleep at the Treehotel. We were nearly 11 hours north of Stockholm, and we hadn't seen a car for hours.
Wow, did you see that? The moose? Or are they reindeer?
Are they reindeer?
I think they are reindeer.
Are they reindeer?
Renos, yeah.
The boat fits the sleigh.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
Mom's Rudolph is alive. Is Rudolph alive?
I don't know. Never seen him. This is the first time I've ever seen a reindeer. How do I know?
There is a small airport nearby, but we had chosen to drive on roads without gas stations or reliable Google mapping.
It says an hour, but on this road, which makes me a little nervous. I hope we don't dead end at the end or something. I have to go back.
Wow. Incoming call.
Some call this Europe's last remaining wilderness. And there are far, far more trees than people.
Thank you. Except that there's a
Treehotel. Is this Treehotel?
Yep, because it's a walk to the other, yeah.
Yeah, it looks like parking.
So Treehotel.
Going to our
house.
There's more, Nikki. This is the biggest one. Do you guys see what's up there? No, but you see it?
Nope.
Yeah.
Do you see that there's something up in the tree? Do you see this tree house? You almost don't see it, do you? Doesn't it feel invisible? You can go see. Yeah, we're gonna have to push a button and stuff for the ladder. There's no ladder.
Up there or down there? Yeah, it's down there.
Come up here.
A spaceship.
No. No.
UFO, do you know that there are those things that people think the aliens use?
You're kidding me. No.
You think you can go up, Mom?
This is like a real spaceship. The light's in the picture.
Okay. It's a UFO. A UFO is.
There's light!
Yeah.
Nikki, then me, then Nikki with Mom.
This is not the safest thing.
No.
This architect is really cool.
Mommy, you're too heavy.
But you have to push with your hands on the doors and they open up.
This is cool.
I'm not falling.
Careful there. Listen, right.
Nikki, stay back. Go back on the bed.
Can I get the fleeces?
Yeah.
The UFO is one of the two tree rooms large enough to fit a family.
Have you picked where you're going to sleep?
Yes, I want this one. Thank you very much.
Oh, wow, that's great. So everyone gets a bed.
No, I want this one.
Let's go!
It's moving.
This is the future, guys. This is the future.
All right, does anyone know how to close this up?
Nope.
All right, guys, 2 minutes, guys.
Our spaced-out shelter was designed by Bertil Harstrom, an architect from central Sweden who wanted to recreate a childhood dream space.
What?
The pod was 30 square meters, round.
It moves. Wiggle around a bit. You feel it?
and it was equipped with the basics of a tiny home.
We are rich in Europa.
Oh, I see. There's water. See, there's water, just that amount. We have a lot.
Dad, we're going into the bathroom. Mom, and we don't even have a...
At least we have our own toilet. And it's an incinerating toilet, so it burns stuff.
That's to do pee-pee.
You need to go pee-pee, but I think even for pee-pee, you're supposed to burn it. You ready to go pee-pee, Nikki?
Go pee-pee?
It's kind of like having a dome house.
It's like a disco dome. It's like a bold idea from a futurist from the 50s or something.
Oh, I can walk now.
This is you have lots of space here.
Yeah, I know.
See?
See if you can find the windows.
I know. One, two, three, four. Scary.
This shape is probably more familiar to, you know, unicellular animals rather than primates.
Sky.
We're going to sky?
I think we are living. We are going in the moon. We are in the moon.
You have lots of space. But as any round design, you always have the geometric challenge of how to divide a circumference, right?
Show me the kitchen. What's in the kitchen?
What did you do? Did you open it?
Yes.
I think in here, since this is not meant to be a house, but a room, they took the right decision, which is to leave everything open.
What, this thing is cozy. This thing is, I mean, you know, let's sleep, you know. Let's take off.
Do you know what?
Let's stay calm, Neil.
Don't turn this, okay?
I have more, Mommy.
I don't know if there's any left.
But I have this.
Okay. It feels like a very nice business class instead of an airplane in a spaceship.
Yeah. Ready for bed? Get your bed.
And I will
hop in bed.
Hop in bed.
Instead of one of these, the biggest Airbus or, you know, the new Boeing, the 7710.
Now. It's late. It's after midnight. In your bed.
No.
Or the Dreamliner. Looks like 20 steps beyond that. That's a room you will have when you go to Mars, you know.
Get in your covers. I'm turning off the light. Yes, I'm turning off the light. Ready?
This is the vintage one in 2050.
Nikki, you ready? Under your covers? Night, everyone.
This place changes with light. In the morning fog, it's part movie set, part fairy tale. And like Alice's Wonderland, reality here can feel entirely subjective. To create this Disneyland in the trees costs a lot of money. More money than guesthouse owners could afford. So the Lindvalls went to a bank to ask for financing.
When we have the land, we get contact with the bank, of course, and try to get the loan and financing the project. We was a little bit nervous about what the bank should say, but they was also very positive and they was interested and want to help us.
Because you had approached the bank and say, we want to make Treehouse.
Treehotel on the countryside here.
Yeah. They understand that? Bankers are usually conservative.
Yeah. No, they find the idea really special. I mean, they can see that it was a new concept who can attract people. So Here we have the dragonfly, the last room we make in 2013. And it was designed by the Finnish architect Sami Rintalan. He lives in Norway. And it's the biggest room. It's 53 square meters. It's a weight of 22 ton. So it's a suite with two bedrooms, it's a conference, it's a toilet, water, shower, everything inside there. And it's covered by metal, but we have just painted with salt and water to create this brown rust color.
What about for support? I mean, that's a lot of weight. What's your support on this?
There are 8 trees holding up the whole building. Oh, okay. All the room at Treehotel is hanging in living trees. That's the concept, yeah. So we have no other support than the trees.
So like the support you see there is just...
The metal beam we just put because this tree was too small, so we make it a little bit stronger. And in 10, 15 years we can take it away because then it's strong enough. The idea here is that we connect them to living trees and you see the metal brackets around the tree trunk and the tree grows every year 1-2 millimeters wider. So every year we open the brackets with the bolts so we don't kill the tree. You must open every year a little bit. If not, you will stripe the tree. But the cables is just to stop the movement in the room when it's windy. Because as I say, 22 ton, when you get that in, get to move that, it's really some heavy. So this is the dragonfly, the big room. It's a family of 4 people from Hong Kong who are staying here for a couple of nights.
Why is it called dragonfly?
Have 4 wings and a tail and a nose. That's the idea. On the walls we have birch plywood. And you have one bedroom here on the left side with 2 single beds. With slide doors so you can close the room also. So there are 2 separate bedrooms in this room. And on the other side is a new room here with a view over the river.
Was it important to have the trees sort of as part of the design? I mean, I see that, you know, the window frame's part of the tree here and...
Yeah, I mean, you need to fit in the trees together with the building, so they're hanging on these trees. So here you have a sitting area for 4, or it can be up to 8 people if you have a meeting. And here's a TV screen for presentations. So the room have Wi-Fi and they have a sound system and everything.
So it's not completely getting away?
No. All the furniture, the lighting system, it's created just for this room, designed by this architect also. So this room have a shower, toilet. We use modern insulation toilets, so it burns everything inside. So it will be just ash, mineral ash. And you can spend 10 weeks daily use and it's nothing left in the bottom. Everything is burned. And then you have it's a shower inside here. This is the water system we have designed. It's a glass tank here with a tap under. You get water like this. And we give 3 liters in this tank. Normally it's enough for 2 guests for one night because it's a very economic system and you can see how much you spend. So this is teaching people that you don't need more than 3 liters to wash your hands and brush your teeth. Now I find the idea in Russia use this kind of system in summer house, dachas. They call them rukamoika.
There aren't many people up in this part of the world, are there?
No, it's very few people up in the north of Sweden. We have a lot of space, each of us. This is the blue cone. It's designed by the Swedish architect Thomas Sandell. It's 2 floors inside there. And it was made a little bit lower because it was prepared for disabled people. The government say 10% must be for handicapped. So we do one little bit lower and easy to access. It's a 4 bedroom, it's a family room. So then we build also 2. This is the first sauna we made in 2010. It's upstairs, it's a sauna and a relax, and downstairs it's a relax room. And that's a new one we made in 2013 because it was too small with one.
And because we're in Sweden, we have to have sauna.
Yeah, of course, that's really important.
Yeah, it's a sauna almost in the trees, isn't it?
Yeah, it's hanging in the trees. It's on. It's hanging on trees with beams under. So it's a real tree sauna, not in the. It's not on the ground. But it's not so high.
Have you spent nights in these tree houses?
Yes, I've been staying in all the rooms. Of course, you need to try them. It's a really good feeling of. It's really quiet up there. And you feel a little bit movement in the treehouse because they are all in living trees, so that really helps you to sleep very well. And it's perfect to wake up with a view of nature.
Okay, ready guys? Should we open?
We're open again.
Because we are leaving.
Is there a shelf?
Be careful, you are too close. We are living the UFO.
Great.
Are tree houses common in this area?
No, the only tree house you can find it was children done, and nothing like this. So you do it when you're a child.
So isn't that crazy that people can't see in, but you can see out, right? People can't see in the windows, but if you look, you can see out the windows, can't you? See that? So nobody can see in, but you can see out.
Papa can't see me.
It's more like to come up from the ground, have a view. And the feeling of some kind of freedom. Nobody can touch you up in a treehouse. And you can look down and see the other people, the nature of the other people down there.
Mommy said it's open so we can go inside.
I think something connected to the childhood.
What's this, Mom?
It's a house inside there.
Can I get in?
You can get in, yeah. You want to get in?
Mama.
When I was young, I would sit up in the trees and look over to other places, and of course, it was a good feeling to stay high up in the tree.
See, that would be a nice place to sleep.
Yeah.
Mom, there's even an upstairs.
I know, a ladder. Yep.
I think it's some kind of dream of an architect to create a small, tiny treehouse. That's something they really want to do.
Could you see me behind the door?
No.
I can see out.
You can see out?
This place just makes you realize how important architecture can be.
That's really important for us. And that's the attraction for Treehotel. You have different design for each room, different architects. And that's create a really big interest. And to see it together with the nature. When the room is always changed depending on the weather, what the sun, cloudy, snow, whatever. It's really everyday change of the view from outside. Something also in the winter, they are interested to see the northern light. To combine that with to stay in a treehouse and see the northern light, that's a beautiful. It's coming new, designing treehouses in many places now. It's a trend, it's something who started for a couple of years ago that come back to the nature, stay in a treehouse, but build it more for more comfortable, more elegant or whatever. So.
Feels great, you know. Why shouldn't we have the house as bold as we want, you know?
What if we just could fly home instead of drive? What if we could just program this to take us home?
It's not gonna work.
No, it's
if it's a spaceship attached to a couple of trees, you know, it's a spaceship. If it's a little hut, primitive hut, that's fine too.
Back to our home planet. Just kidding.
The reason we make it, build it here, that the only reason is that we live here. we don't want to move to another place. We try to attract people to the area.
Instead of moving, you thought, well, because it's a small town, you could have said, well, there's not much work here, right? I
mean, but you must do something really strong and unique to attract people to this place. Yeah. So that's the reason. And we find it.